Yeah, game one for the biggest tournament we've ever had. Here we go. I'm excited for what the day has to hold. And here we go. We have...
This is going to be a big startup today. And, you know, kudos to these guys for coming out. And, you know, Uwe wasn't able to make it for a couple of tournaments. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad to see him again. We like to make sure that we maintain a lot of our original people.
He's definitely a strong player, and he's only 16?
I believe he's 15, unless he had a birthday since last time I saw him.
So. Yeah, 15, 16, something like that. He's a very talented young man. And he's going to be showing us a lot of his skills today, hopefully.
And that's one big thing, too, is also just with PCC, we're not just looking for college-age kids. We're not just looking for adults. We're not just looking for a pro scene that we're trying to start. We're wanting to have something to build a community, and we're looking forward. And a big down smash, calling it just really early. I don't think Bowser was above 80%.
No, getting an early kill on Bowser is always a scary thing for the Bowser. But it doesn't. He seems to be showing signs of life here with 86% on Uwu. You know, that's kill percent for Bowser for sure.
And, you know, this could, especially on the ledge, neither one of these, and I don't really see Fives play before. I've never really seen him go at it.
Right,
but
right.
Bowser as a character doesn't really play off stage as much as a lot of different characters.
Yeah.
And this is going to be a pretty big down smash heavy at the ledge all match, right. I feel like.
Wow, that didn't kill, actually. He was probably going to, if he had gotten it on that platform, it definitely would have killed. But I think he missed it by just a little bit. And the random up, he's going to get punished for it.
I think he was looking to try and cover maybe a get-up roll or maybe just a standard get-up with that.
Oh, okay.
I saw him
okay.
kind of moving around, trying to cover different options, and just wasn't quite able to get enough off of it.
Bowser opting for that upbeat. Ooh!
And the two-frame!
Very nice.
The F-tilt for Bowser, the downward angled F-tilt, covers so much more room than just actual down-tilt does. It's actually pretty funny, but it's one of his best two-frame moves.
Oh, is that
Ooh.
It? All right.
That would have been a very early stock. And this is showing, you know,
okay.
even though Uwu hasn't been here in a while, he's definitely been, you know, putting time in the lab, hasn't
yep.
missed a step. Hopefully, you know, we'll be seeing him go at least a little far today.
Oh, I definitely think he will. Uwu's always got the talent. He's always got a good bit. But, you know, you can't count out Bowser yet. It's Bowser. He can steal a game away in a heartbeat if you let him. Okay, getting that up, he's getting lots of damage, and there we go with the stock.
And there's that big, you know, the fair is so hard to get around, especially for a character like Wolf, who doesn't have a whole lot of air mobility, and you know, he doesn't have a very mobile up B. So you can tell where Wolf is going to be recovering from 9 times out of 10.
Right, and it's not going to take much more. If Bowser can keep it going, he could take the game back if he wanted to.
It definitely could happen.
You're always at kill percent when fighting Bowser. He's got the flamethrower going, an up B.
Damage this is an
up
even
there.
Game. You know,
yeah.
It seemed like Uwu was actually going to have a pretty good lead here, but
yeah.
Five seems to have brought it all the way back to where this is a last hit situation.
Yeah, it's definitely down to the wire now. Seems like the game is heating up for sure, and an up smash.
And the up smash, calling out maybe a little bit of a panic upbeat, but we're getting the crowd really excited here. Everybody popping off. You know, all eyes on stream right now. And this has been really, really important for us.
It's really great. It's fun to see everything going on. People getting excited over this and watching it in real time. It's always great. So we're going to get to the next game now.
My biggest question is where Battlefield sounds about right.
Right.
I would say, you know, you don't want Wolf to be able to camp you out with lasers. So
yeah.
Town and City wouldn't be something that you would want. And I would say he probably got rid of Yoshi's.
Nope.
But we have Game & Watch.
Yeah, it's his secondary, or maybe one of his co-mains. It's kind of everybody's got a co-main in this game.
I was gonna say, it's definitely a new thing that we're seeing here today.
Well, I fought it a good bit of times. It's really good, honestly. Wolf and Game & Watch seem to share a lot of the same properties of being able to just throw out those safe smash attacks and get a lot of pressure going on the enemy and stuff like that.
I'm excited to see what his recovery ideas are going to be as Bowser,
mm-hmm.
Five's recovery ideas, because getting around this Game & Watch is going to be a little tough because
yeah.
if you've got things like the down smash, it's going to cover a lot of space for a big buddy.
When the Game & Watch activates the Avatar State mode, you never know what's going to go down.
But you also have to remember, Game & Watch is very light, and
yes.
one stray hit from Bowser could clean this up very quickly.
Okay, that down air getting caught on that top platform, he's going to get juggled a bit for it now.
And this is where we're going to have to see how much patience Five has, because landing his Bowser against the Game & Watch is going to be actually pretty difficult.
Yeah, it's such a big body and just easily juggleable. And Game & Watch, once he gets you in his juggle strings, you're going to be in there for a while.
Barely missing that platform, almost taking it out.
Yeah.
Game & Watch living to 116%. That's pretty good for you know, against a heavy like Bowser.
Well, all the hard, heavy hits is just being, you know, spaced out by Game & Watch.
So he had that, and we're going to be seeing it.
Oh, the judge almost came out.
And that's good on five for getting rid of that stock.
What?
I didn't know that Game & Watch could keep that.
Yeah, he can keep it through the stocks.
That I honestly thought that was going to be, that was in the process of saying it's a good thing he got rid of that bucket when he did.
No, bucket is a very scary thing, and especially for projectile characters. You never really want to...
So it acts like waft, though.
Yes.
I didn't realize
once
that
you get it, it's a free waft, basically.
Okay.
But, you know, he probably got rid of it immediately just so that he could encase Bowser. That was good.
Going for the hard punish there and getting parried. I honestly think that was a missed opportunity from both of those guys. I would have assumed that we would have gotten a little bit more, but
good.
The two frames
cutting
up the Game & Watch. Hey, man, I thought that was supposed to be invincible. What's all that about?
Good on the Game & Watch, though. He used his double jump to get away from that attack from Bowser a second ago.
Bowser gets to parry that down smash from anywhere on the stage.
Oh, the forward smash. Flamethrower breath. Oh, he got up right in it.
Not the right call.
What's he going to do? Forward tilt missing. The down air not getting off that platform.
That was actually a pretty smart up B from 5, because even though he didn't get the hit to Game & Watch, he didn't get hit by the key, because Bowser does get hit by them through those platforms, as we've seen before.
Right, right. Good on him for shielding that, and that will that take it? It's
and those
getting close.
Up Bs are getting pretty dangerous.
Very strong, and
that's going to be it. That's going to be game 2.
All right, and a taunt at the very end.
I think 5 deserves to feel himself a little bit.
Yeah,
right
he's
there.
Feeling him, smelling himself a little bit. You know, he's getting the little dance on the Game & Watch.
That was a close game at the beginning,
yeah.
And he ended up pulling through almost like Ooh did there at the end. And
Ooh, going
that
to
wasn't
Lila.
The last hit last stock that we saw from the last game.
He's going
so.
Back to Wolf. I thought he would. He went to Lilat, so I'm sure maybe he's going for the hometown advantage.
It's a comfort pick. I honestly believe, of course, Wolf's been around with Uwu's hands for a long time.
Right.
Since the game came out, I think. I don't see him going to be straying away much this entire
time. And I think a big part of it, too, is, you know, Wolf is really good at his combo strings, which, you know, Bowser being such, well, I wouldn't say combo food, because he can get out of stuff pretty easily.
He's combo food, and he's a big body also.
Yeah, and so Game & Watch, I think, not being able to juggle him as much. He was doing good juggling him up in the air, but, you know, this kind of horizontal juggling is probably why he went to Lilat, too, as well.
Absolutely. Another thing you're going to have to be thinking about, too, is these lasers are going to be coming and playing a big role for Uwu right now, especially since Lilat's platforms are a lot lower than Battlefield, so Bowser actually can't bob and weave around him as well as he could on other stages.
Right, right. All right, he's got some blasters coming out to keep him away. Very good on his part. Bowser just forward smashing through it. All right, we're stuck on the platform,
right,
so we're getting down, resetting neutral, and an up smash will take it.
And that's going to be something that Uwu's kind of has as a staple, is he definitely will up smash out of shield more than any of
it works. Why would you go against what works?
Definitely does. And getting caught by the side B right there.
Yeah.
I was honestly not expecting the aggressive side B from Uwu.
All right, that takes it. Probably some little bit of bad DI, but that's okay. We're going back into it with a little bit of extra credit on Uwu's part. Ooh, it's going
and
for it all.
Honestly, I don't know if it should be counted as extra credit against Bowser, because he doesn't really play much till after 60 anyway.
Yeah, no, he definitely has a buffer window. All right. Ooh.
I was wondering if we were actually going to see a jab reset something out of 5 here.
Really good.
That would have been
right.
something new for
you
me.
Better punish
and
that.
Missed the punish on the... That was a big whiff from Uwu.
That's
getting away with murder right there.
Yeah, that could be a big thing. And he's living to 200, and there's the back air.
Easily going to clean up that stock. Bowser sitting at about 180.
Oh, yeah.
It's just too much to just leave.
Oh, that was
and
interesting.
Going through it, I believe, maybe the sour spot of the side B clashed with the flames.
All right. See what we get. The option is to get back on. Up the
Uwu's already got 5 scared for the aggressive side B. You see how far away he was standing before from the ledge.
Okay, another up B. 5 really likes the grounded up B, and it works really well for him.
It's Bowser's best out of shield option.
Well, he's not really using it so much as the out of shield option, but just more as just a good coverage of some of Wolf's options. It's very interesting how he's using it.
And the bear cleaning that stock up at a pretty high percent from all the way across stage. And again, we have this very close Wolf-Bowser set, just like the first game. But
A couple more backers, though, from Wolf, though, can easily take that away from Bowser.
Very easily. This is, I'm seeing lots of shades of game one from this match right here.
Yes. But then again, like game one, you can't count out Bowser just yet. You can always bring it back.
Not get anything. Did he get his jump? No.
Nope. He's good. All right, the get-up attack. One of the best get-up attacks in the game.
Oh, never seen down smash. No, oh, was that poked him through the shield.
I've never seen that kill. That was good.
You've never seen Wolf up tilt kill?
No, never seen that.
It's like it's as powerful as Snake's. It's one of his best kills.